Hi friends, so unfortunately the coronavirus onslaught is still continuing throughout the world. Number of cases is increasing every day. What is the cure for that? So far no cure has been found out, but why the reasons etc. I will tell later. But unfortunately Mr. Trump has been proclaiming, once on one side he is always blaming China and WHO also now, and he threatens to cut off American aid to WHO, saying that it is China centric. And calling still coronavirus as China virus doesn't help anybody. Though there have been a lot of protests against Mr. Trump by the health professionals in US for not giving them the PPE, personal protective equipment, to help them to fight the virus, to treat the patients. But on the other side, without understanding anything, he keeps on proclaiming one magic solution. That is hydroxychloroquine. That is an anti-malarial drug which has been used for 70-80 years. He claims that, citing some study, I'll talk about it, in France, that it is able to make people who have been tested positive for Covid-19 much better and reduces the mortality rates. But he claims that it is 100% proof is there for that, that it is completely cures everybody affected by this virus. And he has threatened, India last week has banned the export of this drug. Because as the cases in India also increase, Indian government might have thought that it may be a potential cure, so we must not export it to other countries. India is in the world, more than 50% of production of this particular drug comes from India, Indian generic drug makers. In fact, last year around 47% of this drug's imports from US are from India. But Trump has already stockpiled 23 million doses of hydroxychloroquine. Though the number of cases, infections and deaths is increasing so much in US, almost daily 1,000 deaths are happening in US. More than 4 lakh people have been inflicted by this virus. But he is stockpiling this 23 million doses. I don't know why. And he has asked India to immediately give, this is our, that's what the word is, this is our medical supplies. And I have spoken to Mr. Modi on Saturday. And he has agreed. If they don't agree, then US may retaliate. That is always a threat. He openly threatened India. And with Mr. Trump, you never know to what depths he will sink, and he will pull others also into the quagmire. Not only he will sink, but also pull others also. But it is another first low in this way of public diplomacy, if we call it the diplomacy he does. And shamelessly, India has lifted that export ban also the very next day. India has bowed to the open threat issued by Mr. Trump. India, which has imposed an export ban just 2 days back after Trump's threat, has lifted the ban and said on humanitarian grounds, India will export this to countries which are badly affected, and also to neighboring countries like Sri Lanka, Nepal, who are also affected. So this is again, you know, without bothering about the situation in India, just to placate Mr. Trump, this decision has been taken by Mr. Modi's government regime. No government will barter away the welfare of its own citizens. Mr. Trump, whatever nonsense he may be talking, at least openly he says is America first policy. But India also, it seems, follows America first policy. But is it a magic potion, something like this hydroxychloroquine? There are a lot of doubts. Even within US, the doctors and the scientists are deeply divided over the efficacy of this particular drug to treat COVID-19. This particular drug has also been used for treatment of some autoimmune disorders like lupus, which causes inflammation and all, and also rheumatoid arthritis, which could cause heart problems also. The reason is our own in autoimmune disorders, our body's immune system gets activated for no reason. It should get activated only when some pathogens from outside enter our body, like virus or bacteria or fungi, and produce antibodies to kill them. But due to some reason, the antibodies get produced for no reason and they turn against our own body cells, destroying them. So this is known as autoimmune disorder. So hydroxychloroquine is known to reduce the response of our immune system. That's why it is used, but not very popular drug against autoimmune disorder. But it has got enormous side effects. It can cause heart rhythm problems. As you know, COVID-19 virus mainly attacks the respiratory system, including lungs, but also affects heart. And to give them some drug which could cause irregular heartbeat, it's like, you know, condemning them to death. It could cause muscle damage, it could cause nervous damage. So it is not very safe to use for common man who doesn't show any symptoms of malaria or any of the autoimmune disorders like lupus and rheumatoid arthritis. In fact, after Trump first announced it on March 19th, immediately lot of Americans immediately went and purchased it also, and some of them used it also, and this spread like wildfire because American president is saying, and in Nigeria there are reports that few people purchased it and took it without doctor advice as a kind of a vaccine. They were not COVID-19 positive at all. And later they were admitted in hospital for poisoning by this anti-malarial drug. Now today, Brazil Prime President also has asked India, you also please export to us also. So what is this? This is really a drug, a magic thing banned to drive away this COVID-19? No, there is no proof at all for that. China first tested this, of course, this drug last month in Wuhan. But it was a very small population and they themselves said that we cannot be sure about the efficacy of this drug. We don't validate it at all. Later, Mr. Trump has based his declaration on a French study. That French study, what he claims, is a very small one of around 42 patients if I am not wrong. And it was published in an international medical journal. And that journal itself has now said that this particular study do not fulfill our standards and we don't suggest anyone to use this. In fact, a straightforward answer was given by the French head doctor for who is heading the team against the COVID-19 disease epidemic in France. I said very clear, one answer, unambiguous, when press people asked him whether hydroxychloroquine is a drug which can be used against COVID-19, his answer is very simple, no. This drug, why the magazine later retracted? Because it was very simple, because it has not followed any of the rigorous standards needed for doing new drug research. The research has to follow double bind, randomized, controlled study. Double bind means neither the participants nor the experimenters should know which person has been given the drug and which person, that is people who are in the experimental group and who are in the control group, who are not given the drug but has given a placebo. Because, you know, to avoid the psychological after, because when the patient or the people who are participating in the trial know that they are giving some new drug, psychologically they may be, as you all know, as some of you may know about Hawthorne effect in US, one of the very famous studies. To avoid that, this double bind is being given. This is what then only the scientific community will accept that. It was not done that way. And the patients just to be, you know, randomly assigned to experimental group and control group, which was not done. It has to be controlled, means the people who are participating in the experimental group and the control group should be as similar in characteristics, in age, in symptoms, in sex. All those things should be roughly similar. It does not follow any of this. Very small study, in fact, 42 patients only, and all the patients come from only one hospital in Marseille. Marseille is a place in southern France, a big city, port city, very close to Algeria. Whereas all other people in the control came from other hospitals. And Mr. Trump claims that it is 100% cure. It is not so. Because out of that 42 people, 1% died. And 1% after developing nausea refused to take further dosages. And 3 people ran away. We don't know about what happened to them. And couple of people were put up in the ICU when this report was published. We don't know whether they died or not, or they came back. So out of 42, I think around 36 got better with this drug. But the magazine which has published itself has said that, sorry for publishing it, this is not meeting our standards of scientific research at all. And this, how it went to US was, Fox News first published it in US. And Trump, who likes Fox News, must have seen that. And is now proclaiming that it is ready to cure COVID-19. And he also tells another lie, that US FDA has approved this drug. US FDA, Food and Drug Organization, works under the federal government headed by Mr. Trump. But even that has not given approval for using this drug at all. It has said that this drug can be used as a test or trial in US. That also under the threat from US. He is threatening sovereign countries like India. Will he not force the one department, health department working under him? But even after his all this bullying, FDA has not given permission for using this drug as a treatment procedure. It has said doctors, if they want, can use this as a trial. But he comes out openly and repeatedly tells that FDA has approved this as a new drug for treatment of COVID-19. Nothing can be farther away from the truth. So it's the standard tactics of the fascist gang, whether they are in US or in India or in any other country, it is the same thing. Keep on telling lies again and again and again, and use your media and social media to propagate it. And slowly people will start believing it. And never be ashamed if counter arguments, more better scientific, rational arguments based on facts are given. Ignore them completely. Never answer them. Remain silent and keep telling your lies and half-truths again and again. Bang, bang, bang. Same strategy what other people in India are also using. He is also using the same thing. And I don't know what is going to happen to the patients who are being used as guinea pigs now. Yes, viral diseases are very difficult to treat, unlike bacterial diseases. Even bacterial disease, bacteria is developing resistance, antimicrobial resistance is separate subject altogether. There are, you know, the only one viral disease which we have completely overcome is smallpox. Polio, we have found a vaccine, so that helps children from not getting vaccine, but still we don't have a cure for polio. There are some antiviral drugs used for certain viral diseases like hepatitis C, etc. But still, as you know, even common cold, which is caused by same type of RNA virus, doesn't have any cure. HIV doesn't have anything at all. So this RNA is replicated. That's a problem. Unlike bacteria, when they come to our body, use certain mechanisms, molecular mechanisms to replicate, to expand, within our body. So we can, the drugs, antibacterial drugs, can attack that molecular mechanisms and prevent them, prevent bacteria or fungi or any other microbe from replicating us. So we can stop that. Whereas virus is not even a living thing, according to the scientists. It has, most of the viruses are RNA virus, doesn't have even DNA double helix structure, most of them are single helix. So they just come and enter our body cells and use our own energy and mechanisms from our own body cells to replicate them, to propagate. So how to kill this virus and prevent it from replicating without damaging our own healthy cells is the biggest thing facing our scientists. This is has been going on. There's no major breakthrough like penicillin, which has come during World War I for antibacterial treatment. So hopefully, it is now more than one century after the discovery of penicillin. Hopefully, we'll be able to make a breakthrough. But it will take time. It's not going to happen in single day. But there should be proper trials. First, probably with animals. And of course, coronavirus has also been found in one tiger in a zoo in US also. So, of course, virus disease is the most threatening zoonotic disease facing humans and other animals also. We know it spreads from animals to humans. But one positive way of treatment is attracting some attention, if definitely not Mr. Trump's attention. Yeah, Washington Post also has, a couple of days back, has given a report why Mr. Trump may have sudden interest in hydroxychloroquine. So another major producer apart from Indian generic drug manufacturing is the French pharma major Sanofi, and it also manufactures hydroxychloroquine and also exports it to US. And Trump, his commerce secretary Mr. Wilbur Ross, who also visited India many times, and one of his very close billionaire friend who is also a big donor to Republican Party and Mr. Trump's presidential campaign itself, all have small equity shares of this Sanofi, which also one of the majors who produce this particular drug, which Trump now advocates it openly and threatens India also. We don't know what are the hidden things, agenda behind all this. Anyway, during the epidemic outbreak in Wuhan, in the second half last month in March, China has tested treating the patients, severely affected patients, with the plasma taken from patients who have recovered completely, who are tested negative. But they have got lot of antibodies of that in their blood. So plasma is nothing but a part of the blood, which is a major 55% of blood is in volume is made up of plasma, which is itself is essentially made up of water. It's almost like a yellowish color liquid because RBCs are removed from that, WBCs, platelets, etc. But it contains clotting particles. If you remove the clotting particles, then it is called serum, which is tested for your various things. Serum tests are taken. Plus it contains proteins, albumin, globulin and all that. It contains enzymes. So it contains the gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen, which are carried by blood. So it the plasma is taken, convalescent plasma. That means the plasma is taken from patients who are fully recovered and then injected. Of course, all the other testing is also done to test for other pathogens. And of course, blood group matching and all those are done. And it is given, injected to patients who are now suffering with the COVID-19. They have seen some improvement, but they are not claiming that it is the thing. But China has now supplied a lot of this convalescent plasma to Italy. So a lot of studies are being also conducted right now in Italy for testing of this particular way of treatment. This is not a new treatment. So this treatment has been done more than 100 years back for Spanish flu, which is also an RNA viral drug. 100 years back, they're doing the Spanish flu. Later it was done for Ebola virus, which affects Africa, which was also used during SARS and MERS also. Maybe this in my opinion sounds much better, because the people who have recovered must have got lot of antibodies with them. So that would help the building of the immunity system for those people who are still affected basically there. Whereas the hydroxychloroquine may work, I don't know. See, I'm a man of science, I'm a man of, by extension, I'm a man of logic and reason and facts. So I am not saying that hydroxychloroquine is cannot be used against COVID-19. But there is, so far there is no proof that it works efficiently against COVID-19. Because almost all the drugs have their own side effects. So it is always whether it the weights you have to take it. The positives and negatives, you have to take it. Cost-benefit analysis, you have to take it before accepting it. So far, we have not done any major proper scientific study which can be accepted by WHO and other members of the scientific community, global scientific community. So otherwise, it is like a quack medicine. What Mr. Trump is suggesting, as things stands now, I'm saying it very categorically, as things stands now, I don't know what tomorrow the studies will say, but as things stands today, on 8th April, hydroxychloroquine is like a quack medicine. It doesn't have any validity, proof against your efficacy. No, nobody has proved the efficacy against COVID-19. But its side effects are very well known, particularly causing irregular heartbeats, rhythm. So we have to be pretty careful in administering new drugs. Of course, we understand, and the swagger Mr. Trump keeps on, because he has to keep blaming. So he has to promise also, like in India, our leaders are promising that coronavirus will go away if you light diya, or we are clapping your hands, or thali bajayenge, etc. Same thing. Here they are shouting on the road, dancing on the road, cracking fire crackers and all those things, etc. There he is playing with the life of the people by forcing the doctors use a drug for which efficacy has not been proved anywhere at all. Right. So this is pretty dangerous when such matters of life and death are taken over by idiots like Mr. Trump, and not by the scientific community. Okay, anyway, let us see. Hopefully, some other tests and other things, a lot of tests are going on, trials are also going for vaccine and all, but it won't be ready for another year or so. But now many people feel that COVID, this coronavirus may become a seasonal flu, with, of course, we have to wait and see. You know, it's too early days probably. As things stands now, the government is likely to announce extension in India, extension of the lockdown. Kerala government has set up an expert committee and has given a report, beautiful report. Maybe tomorrow I'll talk about that report, how to come out of this particular thing. Step-by-step approach, how to come out of the lockdown without compromising the health and restarting economy simultaneously. And some states have also reduced the salary, not only for MPs, MLAs and ministers, but also for IAS officers and all other categories of government employees, whether it is legal or not. Maybe tomorrow I'll talk about all that. Take care, mate.